Hello, everyone. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Welcome to Gaming Scripture and Commentary. Christian gamers playing games, talking about Jesus through His Word, and commenting on anything that happens to come up. Today, special broadcast, because E3 is live, and the first press conference this year is from EA. So my plan is to share that press conference, watch it with you all, and then make some comments along the way, and eventually I'll see what I'm wow about, which I'm not wow about. First time I ever broadcasted E3, but you know, I thought I'd give a chance. See what happens, see who might be interested in listening to my ramblings, and not to mention which, if anyone is watching this, what your ramblings are, whether you're on Twitch or in on YouTube, you know. But before we start this, I always want to make sure that everything I do is for God and give a prayer. So let's pray a prayer. I want to say a prayer for us who are watching, but also for the folks at E3. Help them to be safe. And anyway, Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for the opportunity to share and come together and be with you, an opportunity to share your word, but also watch out for those people who are at E3. Help them to be safe. Help them, Father, to enjoy the opportunity there. Help them, Father, to grow in their knowledge of you, hopefully, even though there's not really a Christian conference, but we want you to, your presence to be known. Help them all to be safe and let them have a good time and enjoy their opportunities to be there with friends and family. Watch over those who are watching this broadcast, be blessed, and those who are searching to find, those who have found to grow more, and for those who know more to reach back and teach and to keep learning and growing. And we ask this in your wonderful, glorious name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. So we got about 3 minutes to go before it lives. Right now, if I was to turn on the sound, you would hear music. So in the meantime, I'm gonna hold back. So I was hosting IGN earlier because they have some pre E3 stuff. They're also going to have a pre E3 thing also. So I would not hesitate. I mean, I would point you that way later on. I plan on rehosting IGN on their comments after the broadcast is over. They did mention some games that might be talked about E3, things that I am interested in and things I'm not interested in, you might say. I mean, clearly, I am interested in Star Wars Battlefront 2. I'm interested in everything I talk about from that point of view. I'm not necessarily interested in some of the EA Sports stuff or racing car stuff, but ho, who knows? We'll see what happens, you know. Everything, I mean, EA tries to be a company for all people because there's not just one monolithic. I mean, even my family, I got 4 kids and each are gamers, but they have a different viewpoint on gaming and what they play. So that's good. You have to have that variety. Now, you can be a company that, you know, likes people who make EVE Online, be specifically targeted to one location and make money. It's great. No problem with that. EA tries to be more. So they also, I guess this whole thing is, if you look at the schedule over here, they have a whole thing going on with the EA Play live stream schedule. I'm not planning on watching all that stuff as you go along. You know, I don't plan on, you know, even though it'd be kind of interesting to see the Star Wars, I mean, Battlefield 1, I've already played. Anyways, yeah, so my plan is just to watch the actual broadcast, you know. So we're about 1:43 to go. I'll turn the music on. What the heck? You can listen to what they're talking about. I hope it's not too loud. Maybe it's just loud for me, I guess. It might. Yeah, I'm going to turn my headphones down, but hopefully not too loud for you all. Tonic Arts, I remember looking at their stock price like 20-odd years ago. Think about buying some stock. Didn't do that. Probably should have. You know, it's one of the things where it's like you don't know where a company's going to go. There are companies who have come and gone over the years, but EA is still around even today. I obviously use their Origin portal for a lot of the games I play with. Battlefield 1, obviously, but it's Battlefront, Star Wars The Old Republic. I mean, everything. Oh, we are in the 1 minute countdown now. Now we're into the final. So they're changed the font size, make it a little more noticeable. They're about ready to go, okay, so, yeah. Oh, there is a... We're having a video first, or a trailer. Let's see what they got. Nothing. Oh, they're just... It's warning us that whoever's watching this, ratings pending to mature 17 because of the fact that you have these different games, so I'm going to be a little bit... So, yeah, obviously, even in watching this game, watching this, if you have, you know, younger people, you might want to be careful about what they're talking about. Maybe turn the volume down for the games you don't want... I'm not sure what the Mature 17 games are going to show here, but I guess we're going to take a chance on that. We try to be just a mature channel that is for all people, to be a safe area as being Christians and all, but not necessarily a spot where you don't hear a thing, because life is full of that too. You can't protect everybody all the time, even though you want to protect your kids to the point where they become adults, really. All right, here we go. I'm watching my other screen. I probably should move. I'm going to type here. So I'm going to type on the main screen, watch it over there. Which means I'll be head turned. Well, that's fine. I got to type. I'm not going to. I want to type while I'm doing this. Let's play! Here's the countdown. Okay, here we go. Oh, really? People wearing the New England Patriots jersey. Yeah, the Seattle Seahawks fan. I don't like that, okay? Are they in L.A.? They brought us from L.A. I guess they're just doing this because of the fact that the Patriots, you know, yeah, whatever. They didn't win last time, you know. Wait. They did win last time. Wait, what? No. I forget who won last Super Bowl. Yeah, Prince of the Falcons. Never mind, you're right.
Kevin, I covered your career at the University of Texas. Where'd you disappear to?
That we put Memphis on the NFL map. Long shot from the depths of the unknown to being drafted by an NFL team.
All their eyes on you. What's to stop you from hightailing again?
Let me ask you something. Why are you here? Because football is my life.
My father used to say, when the world knocks you down, get back up again.
Wade is miles behind.
Long shot. You're gonna get hit today.
You're not the only one trying to get drafted.
No, man, forget you. This time
around. Devin Wade at the line for the final play of the game. It's the biggest moment of your life.
Let's go out there and prove to the world that we belong.
Of course, man. Why not, you know? Right, sorry for the football. Makes sense.
Round of applause for the drumline, guys. That's Madden like you've never seen it. And I might be biased, but I'm pretty sure that's the most innovative Madden we've done in well over a decade. Welcome to EA Play 2017, coming to you from the Hollywood Palladium. This is our second year at EA Play. Last year, we went out on a limb, tried to do something a little different with a view to changing the way you interact with products before they launch. We wanted to do something that put the games in your hands earlier, and it showed us how much further we can go. As you can see, we've built a creative space here. We're right in the middle of it. This is going to be where it all goes down over the next 3 days, playing, creating, and sharing with the rest of the world.
They can't play yet.
We built it this way for a very simple reason. We want more of you to be able to experience this moment.
Okay,
for thousands of you in Hollywood this week, we have hundreds of stations for hands-on gameplay.
This is why E3's...
And for tens of millions of you out there joining online from across the world, you won't hear it just from us. You'll hear it from players right here. They're here to see new things, to ask questions, to challenge us, to tell us what they like, and especially what they don't. They're going to connect with each other and create content. And of course, they're going to play as many games as they possibly can. So let's set the stage for what we'll do over the next hour and a bit. We're going to go deep into 8 new experiences, each with major reveals, massive innovation, and stories that'll pull you in. 2 years ago, we launched Star Wars Battlefront, and we got a lot of feedback. A lot of it positive, and a bunch of it constructive. That's a euphemism for not as positive. So today we're going to bring you 30 minutes of Star Wars Battlefront 2. And what we hope you'll see is that we've addressed all of the feedback and gone even further. We've got a mix of everything here for you. A look at new IP, some killer new trailers, demos, and a bunch of live gameplay. This is going to be a lot of fun. And it should be, right? Because we're all here for one simple reason. All of us share one fundamental belief. And that's that games are the best form of entertainment on the planet. Yeah! They connect us like nothing else. They bring us together across cities and countries. They inspire us. They ignite the fires of competition inside us. Games allow us to do extraordinary things and to be extraordinary in our own ways. Games enable us to be our most creative selves. Whether that's as game makers trying to pioneer new ways to play, or players making each game a unique expression of our own passion for what we do. Games put the power of play in our hands to do with it what we want and to make it our own. So let's celebrate. For the next 3 days, we're here to celebrate play with all of you. And what better place to start than with a game that has taken the world by storm, Battlefield 1. There's more than 20 million Battlefield 1 players out there today, and we've got a lot to share about a revolution that's coming to this great franchise.
Okay, what's coming now?
Let's jump to Battlefield right from
it's
the creative
game.
Part
I played
of the
it. Play. I played it as much as I have. I haven't actually bought the game. Played beta.
Hey everyone, I'm Andrew Galata, producer for Battlefield 1 at our DICE studio right here in LA. I'm standing inside the creator cave at EA Play, where our community is creating new content to share with players across the globe. It's unbelievably rewarding to see more than 20 million players embracing the game, crafting their own memorable moments only possible in Battlefield 1. Let's take a look.
Hey, Noob, I got some questions.
Neebs, of course.
What is it about the Battlefield franchise that's so special and appealing to you?
The thing I find special about Battlefield is teamwork. I'm not good at shooting. Sometimes I like to repair, or heal, or hide.
Oh, I just shot an airplane out with the game bullet!
I'm most definitely proud to be a part of the Battlefield community. I've never been a part of any other gaming community where people are just so passionate about their games.
Everyone in this community is focusing on making this game as best as it can be and expanding on the experiences that we've already had.
No way!
Was mich an Battlefield begeistert, ist die schiere Bandbreite an Dingen, die ich in diesem Spiel tun kann.
Player versus tank versus plane versus environment.
My most memorable moments is what I do with my community, a 64-man army that just does massive, crazy things.
I have made so many amazing friends who have become more like family.
It's something that brought a whole lot of people together. We'll squad up and go and tear it up.
Boom!
You got it?
Oh, I killed them all! I killed them all!
Oh! Oh, got a roadkill!
Oh, a shark?
I'll never be able to do that again in my life! I'll never be able to do that again in my life! Never, ever. That's it. That's as good as it gets. I should just stop playing. I should quit.
He just disabled a moving truck with a grenade while jumping off a horse. Incredible. We love these only in Battlefield moments, and we want even more of them. So we're bringing more ways for you to play. First, Night Maps debut this summer. In Neville Knights
Night Maps.
And Prise de Tahir, you'll need to deploy tactics as you fight through the night in a massive network of trenches. Second, I'm excited to announce a major revolution in Battlefield 1. We're bringing epic battles to the Eastern Front of World War I.
Oh.
In the Name of the Tsar expands Battlefield 1 to the blistering winter in the East. This is the biggest front of World War I. And with it, we're bringing you 6 new maps, the Russian Army, including the mighty Hussar Cavalry, new vehicles and weapons to expand your arsenal, and the iconic Women's Battalion of Death. Finally, we're introducing a richer gameplay experience in both progression and operations mode. By bringing deeper player progression through all new assignments, the ability to tailor your playstyle with specializations, and new multi-battle experiences woven through the fan favorite game mode, Operations. All of this coming in September as part of In the Name of the Tsar. And for the next 3 days, the Lupkow Pass map from In the Name of the Tsar is right here at EA Play. For those of you tuning in, you'll get a glimpse of it from these guys when they share it on their channels very soon. So there you have it. 8 new maps in total, opening up the largest front in World War I with new ways to play. There's never been a better time to be part of the Battlefield community. Now enough of me. Let's give you a first look at In the Name of the Tsar. A revolution is coming.
There's no justice among men. Tsar Nicholas II.
Услышишь гром.
You will hear the thunder and
remember me. И вспомнишь обо мне. Полоска неба будет твердо алой.
Be interesting. We know so much about the Western Front.
Будет, как тогда.
See, Russia wasn't in the war at the end.
В огне.
Hi everyone, I have the privilege of leading our global development teams. 6,000 of the most creative people making truly amazing experiences, including Battlefield 1. Now this summer is going to be huge. So much new content, so much more to play, and so many new ways to play. And there's one more thing we'll bring to Battlefield. Later this year, we're going to give you a new competitive Battlefield experience. We've heard you, you want a smaller, tighter experience focused on team playing. You want all-out war built for competition, and you want it accessible to players and to viewers. And it's coming. I can't wait to share more with you guys at Gamescom in August. Now, competition is at the center of EA today, and we've always thought about it a little differently. We believe in making stars of all our players. Let me tell you something really cool. Last month, I was watching an amazing competitor, Shells. He made it to the FUT Championship Finals in Berlin. 6 months ago, this guy was an unknown. Now he's a worldwide star. And he'll be competing with the best at the FIFA Interactive World Cup Final in August. Now, we want to find more stars, so we're doubling down in competition in ways only EA can. This fall, we're launching the largest FIFA Championship ever, with many ways to compete. The best FUT players will compete in the FIFA Ultimate Team Champions Cups. And in our official football league competitions, you can represent your favorite real world team. It's true, you can. We'll have much more to share, including our Madden plans later this summer. As developers, your passion is what fuels us. Your stories inspire us, and competition like nothing else brings them to life.
FIFA stuff.
Magnificent goal! If anything happens in this tournament, at least he has that.
This is my first time.
This is my first time competing.
I just thought maybe this is something I could do.
So many good players.
I want to beat them too, just like they want to beat me.
Oh, I just don't understand how people think I'm the underdog.
That is confidence right there.
This is the highest level you can play.
There is a real thin line between success and failure.
How nervous are you right now?
It's gonna be a really tough game.
I'm never gonna lose ever in my life.
Wide open!
He's just a person you can hate.
He is an absolute beast.
Lobs it up to Thomas!
I wonder if
we're going to see a handshake. Nope, not going to see it. He's come up in second place time and time again.
And we have a game. Rocky scored it.
Now's the time to stand up.
Skimbo is moving on.
This is what competitive gaming's all about.
Oh, my word.
We're about to crown a new king.
There it is. It's Rocky that is your champion.
And Michael Skimbo.
More esports stuff. All different
He's
things, right? Esports,
ever
playing
in doubt
real
in that
sports.
Game.
I was in doubt the whole time.
These guys are going through something special right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, sitting on your couch, this could be you.
Now an actual FIFA. Trailer.
There's no I in it, I bring it on my team. Who do you wanna holler? Who do you wanna never know? Don't be a sheep when you can be the goat. Great, it's a big time and you never know. Don't show up to my show if you've got no.
I went early, Rog. I went early.
Men in blazers,
we
huh?
are the men in blazers. That's Rog.
Apparently,
the
they
one.
Are
I'm
a.
I'm Dave-O, way less bald in person. We are delighted to be here.
Oh, we really are. Some of you will know us as the hosts of one of the top three most popular football shows ever to be produced in the panic room in the crap part of Soho.
That is true. Somehow, we convince world leaders like Will Ferrell to come talk to us about the fifth best sport in the world.
Oh, we've tricked them all, Dave-O.
Yeah.
And the common thread for us is always football and FIFA. And when I speak to players around the world, they all tell me their experience with FIFA runs so deep, it actually impacts the way they play on the field. That is art influencing life,
It's
Dave-O.
All melding together. Rog, look at this. Look at how the world's game comes to life in FIFA 18. Player personality that differentiates even the talls from the smalls.
They've even perfected the inimitable run style of Raheem Sterling and developed with detail Anton Griezmann's technical ability to suavely fly past all defenders.
And
so suave.
And these atmospheres, Rog, take a look at this. They make it feel like you're in the Argentinian sun with your pasty white legs. And this is massive, Rog. They've now got the ideal athlete helping to develop the game. Is there anyone better and more genetically sound than Cristiano Ronaldo? Could you get anyone better than that?
Well, that man doesn't have a six pack, he's got an eight pack.
You're right.
And EA Sports know the only way to make Cristiano look better is to jam him in spandex and capture his data. That beautiful man, he's yep. done it all. Let's hear it. Back-to-back champion of Europe,
yep.
the La Liga title, yep. Ballon d'Or winner, yep. literally every trophy. And most impressive from our perspective, oh, that beautiful head of hair.
He has hair, Roger. But as huge as Ronaldo has been this past year, there's one story bigger than them all.
Oh, yeah. Peter Moore becoming CEO at Liverpool. Good luck with that one, mate.
Yeah, no, Rog. The biggest story in football is, of course, Alex Hunter, the new hero of the virtual pitch and the star of The Journey. Alex would go on to score more than 360 million goals in his first season.
Wow. Well, that one's true.
Actually, an RPG player in FIFA.
Whenever a good old English national team take the field over the past year, the single name most tweeted, even more than Sir Harry Kane, Alex Hunter.
Yeah, we could have used him today, Rog.
We could have won it all.
Yeah.
Talking about winning it all, though, what a storybook year Alex Hunter's had.
Yeah.
Winning the FA Cup, just 18 years old, barely passed his bar mitzvah. Uh-huh. He's experienced more in his first season than I will in my entire life.
That is true. It was quite the start to a truly amazing journey.
But the life of every footballer is a journey filled with victory, defeat, glory and conflict, dreams come true, and challenges that lie ahead.
So, everyone wants to know, what is next for our man Alex Hunter?
I don't know, Davo, but it seems like everyone's got an opinion.
There is one question on everybody's lips.
What next for Hunter?
Everyone's hunting Hunter.
Alex Hunter is being talked about.
I think always Alex Hunter talk. I think that's just paper talk, if I'm honest.
Sehen wir Alex Hunter bald in der Bundesliga?
Seine Spielweise ist atemberaubend.
Alex Hunter is a global talent, a huge talent. He needs the right club and the right manager.
Any club will be lucky to have him.
Alex Hunter is in the media every day and it's getting annoying, to be fair.
Oh, irritating.
What kind of club would let Alex Hunter go?
I'm not really sure that a move is the right thing for him.
Just put it in your finishing.
But this guy's getting too big for his boots, blood.
Alex Hunter is a great player.
He's a beast. Yeah, she is.
He's very quick.
He's got skills.
Amazing skills.
Hunter is an attaccante phenomenal.
Hopefully he's got good people around him.
Hunter's bombed his bridge.
He has to look after himself.
Go! Go!
I would move.
Rumours have got to stop.
Don't care, Wally.
Alex Hunter, you really are a waste of time.
Will Alex Hunter stay or go?
Are you sure this is what
risky? Not about
the tour of the US.
What does your heart tell you?
If I stay, it will be double.
It is interesting how to play a sports game and having like an RPG where you're actually role playing.
What up, guys? Thank you for having me, EA. If you guys don't know who I am, my name is Jesse Wellens, and I am a YouTube creator. So I am here to talk about Need for Speed Payback. If you guys didn't know Need for Speed Payback,
this guy is having problems.
Yeah, it's a great game. But all right, all set aside, I'm a YouTube creator. Need for Speed Payback is coming out.
This is a YouTuber and he doesn't know what to say.
Executive producer here. He is the producer of the game. Thank you, Nick, for having me.
Hey man, thanks Jesse. Obviously we're really excited to tell everyone about Need for Speed Payback here today, but more importantly, show it. In Payback, you are on a revenge mission to take down the house.
All right.
House
no,
is
they
a
said car games. That rules the city's I'm not
casinos,
into car games.
Criminals and cops, and that
I think
is
it's best
delivering
if you play
it
with friends
a brand
in like
new
a
experience
party,
with wild
but
heist
not
missions, intense cop pursuits, grueling car battles, and jaw-dropping action moments. No longer is it just being about being first across the finish line. We are putting you behind the wheel of an action-driving fantasy.
So Need for Speed has been around for a long time. There's been a lot of new things coming to the game and a lot of old things that people are familiar with the franchise.
Exactly. You know, we're putting a new narrative into the game where you drive three different characters, Tyler, Jess, and Mac, all bringing their own unique playstyle to the game. You drive across cities, mountains, deserts,
too,
canyons in the most diverse open world ever made for a Need for Speed game. There's a lot of great new elements in this game, but also, obviously, a lot of fundamentals like customization. We go way deeper when it comes to visual and performance customizations, as well as introducing something on top of that, something we call derelicts, which are abandoned classic cars that you transform from scrap to stock to supercars.
See, there you
Speaking
go.
Of customization,
take a scrap car, make it a superstock car.
AR-12
so there's some, that has some, especially if you talk about customizing and building
Beetle.
Stuff. I see that.
He's going to be doing a lot more of this customization and gameplay at 1:30 on the stream if you want to come back. But enough talking about it. I'm trying to see.
Okay, 1:30.
Yeah, you know, we're stream. Absolutely very excited to show you the first one of the blockbusters from Need for Speed Payback, called The Highway Heist, that shows that intense action driving experience. So let's turn around and take a look.
Payback. Payback's a beep.
Koenig Zegregera. 0 to 60 in 2.7 seconds. We intercept, then grab the cargo.
It'll be part of a convoy.
What are you thinking?
Quick hit and run. Get me close to the truck and I'll take care of the rest.
Mistake.
Get me close to that truck before it hits the tunnel.
I didn't realize this. Well, I thought it looked deep enough.
We gotta take out those cars.
RPG elements of this game.
Get rid of these guys.
Ooh, took the car out, man. Is your car damaged? Come on. Come on, is your car damaged?
Let's get that truck.
No. His car is damaged, yours is not. Okay, well, that's cool. Catch the truck. She's gonna jump out. Oh, now you smashed it back in that truck. Oh! Of course, your car is still running fine.
There's something much bigger going on here.
What's the play?
Forget the tunnel. We get him before he reaches the city.
Dang, man. Your car is in pristine condition after all those smacks.
Guys, more house cars headed your way.
Down house enforcers. I gotta admit, that's kind of cool to be able to do all this and not have your car get damaged. Ooh.
These guys are tougher.
Freaking tanks is what they are.
They're going down either way.
Oh, just into the telephone pole. But your car, mwah, pristine.
Take him out, Ty.
Guys, Cindy's coming up fast. Jess, I've got a really bad idea.
Mac?
Ladder on the side. You can get up on his right.
It's now or never, Jess.
Do it. Keep it steady.
Jump.
Oh, she jumped right when the car came between them. She's gonna jump in. I'm actually nice that she's not falling off the truck. The truck is just going back and forwards. Oh, there she comes out of the car! I said this car actually has gas in it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Good job, team. Let's take this baby home.
Let's see what she can do. Okay, boys, let's even the odds.
Here come the cops. Right, you know.
I can assure you that plays as well as it looks. Last year at EA Play, we unveiled EA Originals. The program was something we created to support small independent studios, to help bring experiences that are unique, gorgeous, innovative, and memorable to the world. We are partnering with game creators through the process from development to marketing to publishing. But EA Originals is also about funding, about offering a level of security. The profits from these games go back to the hands of the developers. We have been overwhelmed with the indie community's reaction to this. I can tell you, we have received hundreds of pitches, many of them brilliant. And as a result, we now have several new titles in development. Today, I want to introduce you to our next EA Originals title, one that I've been very close to from the beginning. This game tells a story in an entirely new way. Now, a few years ago, I played the indie hit Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons with my oldest daughter.
Never heard of Brothers.
I loved how different the game felt. The mechanics and storytelling were really cool, and we both loved the emotional story. So I decided to contact the game's creator, Joseph Farris. When we met, we instantly realized we shared the same passion for games and how to bring new experiences to players. I also found out that he was building a new studio called Hazelight. Now, we're thrilled to be working with Joseph to bring his new project to all of you. What started out as a wild idea on paper has now turned into a groundbreaking, one-of-a-kind game called A Way Out. Take a look.
What's your plan?
He's light.
Stay the hell away from me, okay?
Your prison breakout? That's what it's all about? You're a prisoner. Let me guess, you're innocent.
I'm sure you have good reasons to bust out of here, but I need to get out of here too.
Yeah? Not my problem.
Ooh, co-op adventure.
It's pitch black. We need a light.
Screw it. I'll go first.
Oh, crap!
You okay? You have a problem?
Yeah, I got a problem with you.
I love you, buddy.
That's it. What are you doing here?
She's my daughter, too.
See? Problem solved.
Come on, Leo!
It's a co-op. Is it co-op because you're playing another player? Or co-op because you have another character that you're playing with, so to speak?
Hey, my name is Joseph Faris, and I'm the writer-director of A Way Out. I'm so excited to be here and show you the game. So, after I finished Brothers, I wanted to make another game that pushed the boundaries on how to tell stories without compromising on gameplay. And this is the reason why I started Hazelight Studios together with the team behind Brothers. And working with EA's originals was perfect for this, because we have the full creative freedom and trust from EA to deliver the game we truly believe in. And that is very important for Hazelight, let me tell you that. So, the idea for A Way Out came to me when me and a friend trying to find a co-op game that wasn't just a drop-in, drop-out experience. I wanted to play a game where the characters had unique personalities and goals. A game where me and a friend can embark on an emotional journey together. And this is exactly what A Way Out is. The game is designed for split-screen co-op only, and I mean only. So you will be able to play it online, but to get the full experience and feel, we want you and your friend to play it in your couch.
It's and only split screen.
Gameplay wise, yeah, couch tonight, right? Action. Finally, yeah. And what was I going to say? Yeah, let me tell you. Okay, wait, it's coming to me. Come on. Gameplay wise, it's going to be crazy. It's going to be a huge amount of variation. You're going to be able to play everything. I mean, not everything, but a lot of stuff. There's going to be exploration, driving, action. So you won't get tired of this game, I'm telling you. So, but let me tell you this.
You know, if you're alone like me sometimes, how can you play split screen
out,
only?
I will tell you, you will play a co-op game like never before. I know, I mean, I can guarantee that. I know I sound very cocky, but I can't help it because it's true. I'm so pumped up, it's crazy. You don't know, I live
pump
this game.
Him up.
I'm telling you, it's like,
well, he's pumped up. He's
ass
a director and writer of the
ass
game. I was expecting to be pumped
so
up.
So right
this
now,
game.
I will show you a gameplay video that's going to show you just a small part of the game, but
so
still, you're going to get blown away.
Is it really
and
only split screen? You mentioned about online
so
too, but he said it's basically only split screen play.
How fun it is to be here and do these games. It's so much fun. And also,
I agree that playing
thing
with somebody else is the best fun to play.
To my Hazelight
but you don't have the opportunity
watching
then
live from Sweden. Thank you. Goodbye. Hop shaky. Boom. Come on.
Here we go. We're going to see this actual play. What? Nothing is but screen, though. I want to see both screens.
A story-driven co-op game. It is
designed, there
we are.
Now it's screen.
And experienced only in split-screen co-op.
Only
which means
in split-screen.
You have to play the game with a friend, either online or on your couch.
Oh, you
the
can't play online.
Prison. You play as Vincent.
He said.
And Leo.
So you can do it.
You and a friend
you know,
will get to know
your
characters
and
unfold their story
you
together.
You don't know anything about me, man.
Maybe not. But hardly
okay, that's good. You can
play
somebody else somewhere
me
else then.
With or without you, I'm going after him.
Let me show you some of the scenarios in the game. On the right side, you see Liu, who's already in prison. On the left, you see Vincent, who just arrived. Now, if you look to the right again, you can see that Liu can be controlled while Vincent is in a cutscene.
Oh, that's cool.
Here's another one. Vincent and Liu are now in the laundry room. Your goal is to smuggle sheets using a laundry cart. You can approach the scenario in different ways. Either get the cart with Vincent.
No, I got a good pack right here. I think it's got your name on it. It's broken. I don't know.
Or with Liu.
Get away. Oh, I see, yeah. Idiot.
Yeah, but I think those two guys are just about to fight.
What the?
What? Who's him?
Yeah,
what? In a way out, you will experience something new all the time. Everything you do in the game is unique for that scene. We want you and your friend to be focused and engaged throughout the entire story. But let me tell you, this is just the beginning of what you will be experiencing in A Way Out.
You know, it has merit, and this game does have merit.
Get him!
It's kind of cool, but I'm not sure about the whole idea of co-op only. Well, no, yeah, that's fine.
Relax,
he's like,
man, I got this.
Get a friend, get online, say you plan out, say Tuesday nights, 8 o'clock, 2 hours, let's play this game, I guess, you know. Coming early 2018.
I know, me again. Thank you, Joseph. That game is absolutely stunning, and I can't wait for you guys to get your hands on it. Now let's switch gears for just a minute. It's great to be here showing you the games you'll play this year. But at the same time, we are inspired to look farther ahead. Creative ideas combined with new technologies become an unstoppable force. We have teams today taking technologies that are changing the world and using them to change the way we play.
You're going to say VR? Don't say VR.
Is it the futurists, the incubators, our talented
we
artists,
know VR is coming,
designers,
but...
and engineers within our studios, our Frostbite team, our digital
Frostbite
platform
engine,
team,
you know.
And a new research division called Seed. What motivates me every day is the responsibility we have to push our industry forward. That's one reason we created this new division. Seed is a small, stealthy
extraordinary
team that I work with on a daily basis, exploring some of our most visionary concepts, like deep learning or neural
networks, division.
Creating a world for you to define, to interact with, and share as you wish. Or virtual humans with deeply sophisticated artificial intelligence. So instead of one main character shared by millions, we can have millions of main characters shaped by you. That's just the beginning of how we can blur reality and the digital world. Go anywhere, share your discoveries, be anyone. The games become yours. Now, what we know
games
today
become
is
yours.
That interactive entertainment will change more in the next 5 years than it has in the last 45. Together, we are building that future.
Interactive.
One that disrupts, empowers, and is full of play. And to do that, we also need innovative new platform technology. So when we were thrilled when we got our first project Scorpio dev kits from Microsoft, 6 teraflops and true 4K graphical fidelity. Now, these Madden NFL 18 visuals are just a taste of what can be accomplished combining
Scorpio?
Frostbite with
wow.
Project Scorpio. And already, we are creating the most detailed, high-resolution environments
that's
you've ever seen on a console. Madden looks absolutely stunning, but as game makers, awesome graphics and effects are just the beginning. The game has to feel amazing as well.
Well, yeah,
Project
storyline
Scorpio
too.
Is a powerful platform, and it's coming at the right time. Now, I have one more thing before I go. New IP is one of the purest forms of innovation in our industry. A brand new idea combined with the latest tech and a vision for something extraordinary. The next game will push every boundary for you.
All right, what's your new
IP? It is vast,
IP.
Dangerous,
what?
Beautiful,
what?
And unexpected.
What?
So this is just the first tease
that
we're showing
it.
You today.
Oh.
Then we will have so much more in the Microsoft press conference tomorrow, so don't miss that.
Microsoft press conference,
now,
of course, you're going to show more tomorrow on the Xbox One.
Here's the first
glimpse
of our brand new IP from BioWare.
BioWare? What's it called? BioWare. Frostbite Engine, okay.
The wall.
What What is this?
It's our armor.
Dystopian future?
From what lies beyond.
Wait, dinosaurs? Wait.
But out there, you either live with the choices you make.
Wait, you're in an armor suit?
Trying to change them.
A mech armor suit? It's called Anthem?
The story doesn't end here. It's just the beginning.
Anthem. Looks futuristic sci-fi, maybe also some old, I don't know.
Hey everybody,
more
I'm Sean O'Brien,
I guess, at Xbox One.
And I'm here today to share the latest about NBA Live 18 with you. But instead of talking about it, I'd like to show you. We've spent the last 2 years completely overhauling virtually every aspect of gameplay. Now we're going to go outside to a hands-on station out in FanFest, so you can check out some of those improvements. And then we're going to come back in here and give you more details about how NBA Live 18 introduces an entirely new way to play a basketball game. We call it The One. Gibbs, Connor, over to you.
Thank you, Sean. You look fantastic every single time I see you. We are here out at FanFest EA Play. I want to see everyone on social. Use that hashtag EA Play. Tell me what games you're excited to see. I am telling you right now, I am excited to see a first look at NBA Live 18, and no one better in the business than my guy right here, creative director Connor Dugan. Connor, let's take first look NBA Live 18.
Yeah, what's up? I mean, I'm super excited that people finally.
Have you noticed my mind's distracted now
NBA
because
Live.
I don't care about NBA Live 18.
Just got you and I were playing. I'm controlling LeBron. Q's controlling KD. Let's take a look.
Get all these angles in here. I want to see the sweat.
All right. So what we're looking at here is I'm using my right stick dribble control. I'm performing any combination of moves I want. So I can go behind the back, between the legs, and now I'm trying to attack the basket. But KD, or Q, cuts me off with a flick of his left stick, and then I try to go back at him again. This time I'm going to go middle, but Q's late. He doesn't hit his left stick. He misses the timing window, and now I have an open lane to the hoop. So we see Zaza coming over.
Tell me he finishes strong.
He does.
Tell me he finishes strong.
I use my right stick to finish with the left hand, as you can see here, right over top of Zaza, finishing away.
Oh, Cavaliers.
And then there we have it. LeBron's looking like LeBron. Nice tight shot.
Classic
Cavaliers
LeBron,
won.
That's what it's all about right there. I appreciate this first look at NBA Live 18. Sean, back to you.
Thanks, fellas.
Warriors, Cavaliers won.
We're excited for all
the Warriors
of you to get your
actually lost their first
18,
game,
and everyone will have an opportunity to do so through a free demo coming in August. Now, this demo will give everyone the chance to start The One and be introduced to this new basketball world. Jumpstart your own legacy through solo, co-op, and multiplayer experiences, and carry all of your progress over to the full game. Now, let's take a look at The One.
NBA Live 18 is an all-new way to pursue your legacy. Centered on you, your journey is defined by the choices you make. Welcome to
Seattle, or not Portland.
The One unleashes the freedom to play how and with whom you want. Here, the respect you earn on the streets matters just as much as the rings you earn in the league. Rise through the ranks in the league, an authentic NBA experience, where you dominate the hardwood on your way to winning championships. But the new NBA Live goes beyond the league, taking you into the streets, where the rules and how you earn respect are different. Team up with friends to take down NBA legends at historic courts like Venice Beach. Throughout your journey, your on-court performance leads to increased skills and new gear as your hype builds in both the streets and
the league. An RPG type
from
thing,
Venice to Rucker Park and everywhere in between. Join the community with 5-on-5 pickup games at iconic, real-world courts. Hit the Drew League and continue to build your legacy in the Pro-Am Tour. Earn the right to go head-to-head with the very best and show off your signature style. From East Coast to West Coast, from the streets to the league, everything you do matters. Your legacy is defined by you and how you choose to play. This is your world. It's time for you to be The One.
Thank you. While you're watching this, some of you might watch this. EA has a full day of stuff. I mean, a whole area. It's just them. That's why they're the only ones today announcing anything. There's two companies tomorrow, and two to three here on Monday.
Thanks, guys.
Tomorrow's Microsoft
and
Bethesda.
Thanks to all of the teams here sharing games today. And a special thanks to Joseph and Hazelight. How about that for some passion? Now, we've got a massive finale coming up here in just a moment.
Massive finale.
30 minutes of pure, unadulterated Star Wars. But before we get there, I wanted to pause for just a moment. Last week, we did something pretty amazing together. We held our annual EA Play to Give campaign, celebrating the importance of inclusion and play in our communities and in life. We partnered with three outstanding charities, the United Nations He for She, and anti-bullying organizations, the Pacer Center and Ditch the Label. We donated $1 million to these three great organizations in support of building a more inclusive world. And here's where play comes in. All of you, our millions of players out there, joined us in support of inclusion. You came out in play in 9 in-game challenges. And by coming together, we are showing the world what a positive force that games can be. And to thank you for that, we're opening ways for you to play a bunch of great games for free. Starting today for the rest of the week, Origin Access, as well as the Vaultlin EA Access, are free. For PlayStation 4 players, we'll also have a bunch of free trials running all week. We're talking FIFA, Madden, PvZ Garden Warfare 2, Star Wars Battlefront, and much more. So jump in, bring your friends, have fun with some great games this week while you're getting ready and excited for what's to come. Now, without further ado, we bring you Star Wars Battlefront 2.
30 minutes worth? I mean, John Boyega. Well, fans, get up. Did really jump back and ask that question? Offline story mode. Well, that's true, though. That's one of the things that people had a problem with Battlefront. It's a Battlefront is a fun game, but it would be nice to have a story mode. There you go. They'd like to be one of those guys just in the costume.
Hello. I'm Janina Gavankar, and I play Commander Iden Versio, leader of the Inferno Squad in Star Wars Battlefront 2.
Oh, you got the Dasho actress do this. That's cool.
I'm also an advocate for in-depth cinema-caliber story in games. That tweet from John Boyega was like the tweet heard around the world. It spoke for all of us. When can we play a Star Wars story? We don't want to just relive the movies. We've watched them a million times. What we want to do is have a new and authentic, untold story. A story that delivers new perspectives and enables us to play as some of our favorite Star Wars characters while also introducing new ones. And just like Rogue One tells an essential Star Wars story ahead of A New Hope, Star Wars Battlefront 2 will tell a new Star Wars story that helps bridge the gap between Return of the Jedi and The Force Awakens. It's good. But EA didn't just stop there. We loved the previous Battlefront of 2015, but we wanted more. Star Wars Battlefront 2 is much bigger than the previous title, with more than 3 times the content of the first game. Yeah. Now, I'm all about that couch co-op, and they're bringing it back with the return of Skirmish, so I'm going to be cuddling up with someone playing me some Battlefront 2. In multiplayer, there are more heroes, more vehicles, more planets. I've been to some of them. More space battles and starfighter assault, and deeper progression and customization, as well as content from across all eras. But, as we know, Star Wars is not just some checklist of great features. How does Battlefront 2 play? The team at DICE in Stockholm has some of the most talented multiplayer designers in the world, and they've been working with the EA Game Changers to make sure Star Wars Battlefront 2 has the multiplayer we're all looking for. These Game Changers, they basically get like tapped on the shoulder because they're the best Battlefront players in the world, and then they get secretly flown out to Stockholm. As long as they provide valuable feedback, they get an early look at the game. Sounds like an awesome program, and if I didn't suck at multiplayer, maybe I'd get an invite. That's true. So, let's hear more from them about their time at DICE.
After the release of Star Wars Battlefront 1, the community thought there should have been more. And the good news is this, the developers have been listening.
I'm really excited to let the Game Changers get their hands on the game.
This is gonna stay, right?
Sorry?
The clean UI look is gonna stay?
There's still time to change something if it's not working.
Oh my God!
My first impression with the game is upgraded. All three eras are gonna be in the game.
No! Girl Squad's coming at me!
Oh, okay, Battle Squad!
We've got a whole bunch of new features. One of the biggest ones that a lot of fans are excited about is the class system.
They split the characters up into different classes.
They have different weapons, special abilities that you can customize.
It affects your health. It affects how you are going to support your team.
There's going to be more content. You're going to have to get used to a lot of new different techniques and how to play.
The gunplay and the weapons have completely been redone compared to the first Battlefront. Now there is a lengthened skill gap in it.
Feels a lot better and go, oh, okay, this gun feels kind of more real, less floaty.
Which is your favorite hero so far?
We're introducing a system called Battle Points, which will allow you to become not only heroes, but other things on the battlefield.
As you're helping your team play the objective, you gain these points.
There's such a plethora of things to spend it on, vehicles, or even coming in as a
hero.
That's
cool.
And the coolest thing, I think, is a level of customization, not just from a weapon standpoint, but the actual character's own abilities.
Collaborating with the Game Changers is always a really great working environment when you're trying to figure things out.
I mean, to know that you're giving key feedback to make it a better experience for everybody, it's like putting your footprint out there and saying, look, I'm part of this.
All right, is everyone in position?
Yeah.
Ready.
Everyone ready?
So I'm going to participate in making the trailer. It's a whole different level of fantasy.
All right, recording.
So in 3, 2, 1.
And now, on behalf of the EA Game Changers and DICE, this is the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2 multiplayer gameplay.
So this is what I think I heard Neeb's gaming talking about, them playing still Mountain 64. All right, guys, time to enjoy a bunch of Star Wars Battlefront 2. Looking pretty cool, you know? This is Darth Maul. Obviously not the game itself, it's just a trailer a little bit for the game. Roger, roger. Ooh, they're gonna destroy the Naboo. Another bowcaster with the Wookiee. Ah, Yoda. Size doesn't matter. As oh, there we go. Rey inviting Kylo Ren.
All wait. We're coming up on the Star Destroyer, but we need to clear that escort. Let's give him everything
we got.
Millennium Falcon.
Here are next assignments. They are unusual.
Grab onto something.
I'm trying.
I do find it cool about the idea of watching it from the Empire point of view, because not all the Empire people were bad. They have to be misled. Okay.
Yoda, Darth Maul, Wookiees, Kylo Ren versus Rey. I watched that thing like 20 times backstage with my mom before this even started. My mom's here. Yes, it's a big day for me. I'm sorry. So. Okay. So we have even more exciting things for you. In just a moment, U2 personality I, Justine, shoutcaster Alex Goldenboy Mendez, and DICE developer Paul Kesslin will showcase Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront II's multiplayer. Yep. We've got 39 game changers ready to go, head-to-head in a 20 versus 20 match, Battle on Theed, and I'm going to take the 40th slot. We'll see. Okay, but you're not going to want to miss this, because like maybe you've seen some teasers, but this is the real thing, okay?
The real
all the bells
thing.
And whistles, all the newness. But before we take you there, another big Star Wars Battlefront fan has some exciting news.
Hi, yep. Guys. It's John Boyega here.
Yep, of course.
Thought I wasn't going to turn up. Yes, I was. But I'm sorry I can't be there with you, because I'm doing a play in London. But I do have some great news. Obviously, you know I'm a massive fan of Star Wars Battlefront 1. And now we're going into the next chapter with Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'm very, very excited to share this news with you. We've seen Yoda. We've seen Luke. We've seen all the other characters. But where's Finn?
Yeah, where's Finn?
Finn will definitely be a part of Star Wars Battlefront 2 alongside with Captain Phasma as part of the first season of free content. And there's more. On top of that, we also get to play on the new planet Krayt that you saw on the Last Jedi teaser trailer in April. So this is going to be an exciting time. I'm going to be playing. If you see Finn running around whooping some ass, it's me. So I'm getting ready, getting set for you guys to play with me on Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'm excited. Let's play.
Let's play. Yeah, that's cool.
Okay, but did you listen? Finn and Phasma are headed to Star Wars Battlefront 2 this holiday, and it will be free. Yes. The team at DICE heard our feedback loud and clear on the previous Battlefront and are committed to keeping this community together with themed seasons of content post-launch for all players at no
additional. I'm excited. Let's get ready to pre-order now, I think.
So,
this is the biggest one so far, I think, of all the things I've seen here at EA.
Jedi is only the beginning of the additional content coming to this game. All post-launch heroes, maps, weapons, and vehicles will be free for everyone who owns Star Wars Battlefront 2. Yes. And yesterday, EA announced that players who pre-order will get early access to multiplayer beta and Yoda's epic lightsaber mastery star card. So, let us recap. New essential Star Wars story. Multiplayer across all three Star Wars eras. Space battles. Split screen co-op. And free content that will keep us playing together for years to come. Yes, right? Yes. Yes. I'm so honored to be just a tiny little part of this team making this amazing game. I can't believe they let me do this today. And I can't wait to play the game in its entirety in November. And I get to start right now. So I'm going to go pick up my controller, and I'm going to throw it over to iJustine and Golden Boy and Paul to take us to Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer.
Thanks so much. Hey guys, welcome to the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer gameplay, Assault on Theed. We're ready to show you guys the live gameplay for the first time. I'm your host, iJustine, and with me here today, we've got Golden Boy and Paul Kesslin, producer from DICE. What have we got going on here today, guys?
We got a lot going on today. First of all, what we're going to see today is a three-stage mode. It's our new gameplay. We'll be showing people going. The droids are attacking Theed. They'll be going all the way up the main pathway towards the Royal Palace. They need to escort the MTT tank. From there, if we progress to stage two, the droids.
Technically, the EA press conference is over. Now comes the next half an hour
of Star Wars Battlefront 2. And there, the droids will ideally.
So I'm going to keep streaming this portion of it, and then go out. But oh my gosh, this one is what I'm wild about.
The fact that we get to be droids in Star Wars, this is going to be awesome. I can't wait. Are you guys excited? Man. You guys got to come alive over here because we're going to see some great gameplay. We have some great, great game changers who are going to be competing here. And I use competing as a term because these guys are holding nothing back just yet.
Yeah, no, it's been super exciting. And we got a chance to play yesterday. And it's just really fun to sort of get into this environment. You know, it's something that we've seen in the movies, but we were actually in the gameplay and with somebody here who has actually worked on the game. So let's talk more about what we're seeing here and getting into this, because there's three phases to this. So currently, we're in phase one.
That's right, and also we have some great game changers. You saw one of them pop up in just a little while. It was VF Updates, Pool Shark, Moosel. We also have my boy Darkness, a.k.a. Dankness. He will be playing as well. We have Wesley, Master Chief, Star Wars HQ.
What is
and
that?
And some NBA Live, just because. Why not?
Yeah, I was like, what?
But anyway, here you go. So Star Wars Battlefront 2, folks.
There you go.
Now, this is awesome because essentially phase one, you get to escort an MTT down the street of Theed here, and the pressure is
wait,
on.
Wait, escorting? You mean like Overwatch?
Back the assault here, Paul.
They do, definitely. The
well, he's playing one of those Battle 1 droids.
If they're successful, we go on to that phase two. But right now, what we're seeing
nice
is some specialist gameplay from, I think, Battlefront updates.
Yeah, let's actually talk about the specialists. And also, you're going to see a couple different classes here. This class in particular, that Master
oh, yeah,
that's
right. Septus versus Public.
Class.
These are not the Empire.
Sniper, right? But exactly. Heavy class, what do they do here?
So the heavy class is great. They got a bit more health than your average trooper. They're also able to pop that combat shield, try to push into areas. So you can see those guys as pushers or defenders in some areas. But it looks like we got one of our vulture droids right now. Not sure who's flying this guy, but these
that's
guys
right.
are great at air-to-air, trying to take out those other ships that might be coming in, that Naboo N1 Starfighter. Otherwise, right. they're there to provide some great ground support like we're seeing here, trying to get some strafing runs in on those cones.
Ooh. Oh, no!
Oh. Missed that tower.
You just did it wrong there, buddy.
So
sorry
it's great
about
we also do have the air support, but we also have ground support as well.
We do. So another thing that those air vehicles are great at is trying to take out some of the ground vehicles that you may see. The droid army has the AAT tank, something that's really great at troop suppression. But we see here a little clip of the V-Wing doing that. Oh, man, he's just mowing some droids down there.
Yeah, just absolutely shredding. You're going to see this happen quite a bit, especially in this phase, because there's a lot of open field here, right? And you can just come through for some great bombing runs, really, and eliminate as many people as you possibly can. And also, you put the presence of an air vehicle out there.
Using it all day, you could probably watch this.
And they will, look for cover in this map where it's already difficult to find
later
cover
on,
to begin with in this phase.
Absolutely, and you can see right now that there is an AAT tank sitting around on the battlefield. He is probably taking out those clone troopers, but this vulture droid is really stepping it up.
What I love about this is everyone's like, oh, look at this great open map. And then when you start phase two, it's like everything starts coming in and coming way closer together. And we're
Absolutely.
Talking a little bit more about the assault class. So for somebody who has just started playing this, never played any previous versions, do you feel like the assault class might be something perfect for them to pick up?
I think the assault class is yes, absolutely.
The biggest thing about playing this game, Battlefront, is you're in the Star Wars universe.
Assault class is something that a lot of players will be able to jump right into. They're your frontline flanker attacker.
Just think if you took like the Overwatch and made a Star Wars,
right,
okay? It'd be like, oh my gosh, you know.
Run and gun action. Their signature ability, you see here at the top of their screen, your number two ability, that switches you over to a shotgun. You get a little bit faster. And you're able to really get in
these
there.
These are good players. Just not like my kind of playing, okay?
I love using the shotgun, man. It is so good. And it's actually, when I first used it, it really caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting it. And I said, wait a minute. I could destroy people with this. So I just charged into the room and just absolutely shredded everyone. It was so fun.
I'm not very good at flying,
to play with here.
We've
also seen some great dogfighting here between the clones and the separatists. This is certainly what a lot of folks love in Star Wars, and just really in any game that DICE makes, right? They just
trying to
always
get,
do a good job.
Trying to get ahead
He's
of it.
Really trying to track him down. This vulture's
not
really
having much luck.
No, yeah, that vulture cannot shake him.
Well, so we got Star Wars HQ here. You know, he's playing the assault class again, and you saw that he has a signature thermal detonator that he'll be able to kind of suppress some of those guys with as he rushes in.
And there are different weapons as well. Like one of the guns that I would oftentimes use was the semi-automatic gun.
Oops.
It, you know, fired a lot slower, but you can get some great shots with it.
Got a tank going on here.
Nice, compact, SMG style. You know,
yep.
Blaster.
Pre-alpha
really
build. Not even alpha. Pre-alpha.
That was, you know, using a little,
I mean, we want to give you a little bit more weapon variety this time around, you know?
Yeah.
Also, some AAT tank action here, and this is that doing what it does best. He's suppressing that point, trying to keep those clones out of the way.
They're trying to make their way forward as the objective continues to march down. He has to get away from that.
He's trying to, I don't know, is he trying to flank the tank? That's not smart.
I don't know, man.
Well, no, what?
Maybe he will. Maybe
you saw a little combat roll there. Got to give you some escape options in case you get
Why not flank
some,
the tank?
I'm
behind
action.
The tank.
Uh oh, we didn't get to see this one before.
Well, that's
finally.
A shame.
Oh, we haven't.
Some ATRTs, yes. So these are great for taking out those AATs. So these guys are a little quick. They have an ion charge ability. That way they'll be able to do a little bit more extra damage against the tank should they see it. So you can imagine like three or four of these on the battlefield really rushing around points. Like, look at this. He's just
can you stop someone
through.
Out? What can you do with this?
Take a little battle B1 battle.
Oh, I was actually going to say, could I get shot off of it if I'm on top of it because my body's exposed? That question was answered, you know, instantly.
Almost immediately.
Yeah, almost immediately.
Separate.
Oh, man. So, Mr. Muselk here. You know, look for this guy to be on a tear a little bit later as well. And also, I did want to highlight, we had an officer, as a matter of fact, right in front of Star Wars
HQ. We did,
HQ
one of my
there.
Favorite classes.
What is it about the officer that makes it so unique?
I mean, my Twitch skills aren't where they used to be. I'm
Fair.
A bit slower nowadays. But I'm able to really buff up my class, or buff up my teammates, try to let them get some extra health, let them push through the points faster. And,
what happened there?
Finally, some good dogfighting going in there.
Okay,
so
all right. And one starfighter.
What's great about some of these starfighters is these are accessed through our new battle point system. So instead of finding a pickup token on the map like we used to in the last game, you're now able to, depending on how well you do, whether you're scoring points via kills, via assists, or you're playing the objective like we really want players to do, you're earning points continuously that
it's
will allow you
how.
To spend those on.
Oh, they're acting like human because humans are playing them.
Hero.
Versus just being robots.
That allows you to unlock all of those things.
All those things, definitely.
And also something to look out for, too. When we get into phase two, that's when battle points are really going to play a role there, right?
I mean, right now, definitely, you see a lot more. It's an open space. You have time for this air combat and some vehicle gameplay. But once we get inside, it's going to be a different story.
That's right. Things are definitely getting to heat up. And what is this happening?
Mr. Bustle?
This is Lock-On trying to shake him out?
Yep.
Yeah, nice. They better enjoy their air combat here, because that's not going to be happening for much
tank.
Longer.
Oh, Master
much
G longer, is definitely. Just destroying yep. him.
Oh, got hit.
Nice job.
But he was doing what he needed to do, support his team, right? It's that combined arms fire. You want to make sure that somebody's trying to cover you from the air.
Oh, boy.
Killed again.
And you can see after every respawn as well, you get those
how many points you're earning.
Right?
That's
so you
right.
can use those later on. Got some specialist gameplay here as well. Maybe you can take off a couple faces, perhaps. That
and so in the specialist
good.
Class, you can also deploy different types of traps as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, absolutely. So they have access to a trip mine. So if you want to sit there and you want to be, you know, that true sniper character, you set up some trip mines behind yourself, make sure nobody can flank you. But really, you're there to provide some of that cover fire for your troops downrange. And it's especially potent in this area because it is such a big open area. So that specialist will really shine in phase one.
Some more bombing runs here and just absolutely tearing them up. I have to say, man, Muselk is killing it in this world.
Again, he's doing great. Oh, and we see there one of the officer classes right next to one of the clones.
Officer is fantastic for pushing, right? You want to be able to push the objective.
Definitely.
Support your team. Like,
definitely.
Support your team like your buddies. If you are playing with your buddies,
to have at least one officer available.
One officer available.
Deluxe edition.
I mean, they really help push. I mean, they really help push. When those heavies are trying to drive towards a point behind you,
got you
some extra help. They give you some extra help. Still able
to
do that push. Still able to
keep
that push. If you're more on the opposite side to lock down a point, the officers have access to a turret that they can place on the ground. And, you know, give it a little bit more fire support for that area.
Standard edition gets all these things.
Really
pre-bombing
runs.
Deluxe edition gets it automatically.
Go into combat with
so why would you
up there? There's a darkness 429 just shredding everyone up here. Maybe he can get a couple kills.
He just went into siege mode.
Yeah, this is happening.
Oh, yeah, so tell us about the siege mode.
Sure,
how does this play out?
In siege mode, for a limited time, you're able to just blow up some huge area effect shots. You lock down your position, but you're able to have a lot more firepower.
We also just saw the B2 super battle droid there as well. That's something you can
get with
battle
points
as well.
Another one of my favorites. Yeah, you can grab those guys via the battle point system. Those guys, great at pushing points again. You know, they have high health, a lot of rapid fire. Oh,
here we go.
Oh, there it is.
And this big explosion indicates phase one is over. Now we start phase two. And this is when the action really begins to pick up here, because it gets really tight inside of that building, and players need to be mindful of that and look for this V2 to just shred through everyone, especially with that cooling ability that he has, to be able to keep him just constantly shooting in the fight.
He's gonna make a huge difference here as the fight moves inside. I mean, there's gonna be narrow pathways. He's gonna be able to just shred as soon as anybody gets in his way, because it's those narrow corridors, it's gonna be trouble.
And just waiting for the prime opportunity to push up here. Player's falling. Got, you know, white boy there.
Here we go.
Darth Maul,
sorry.
This is where it starts to get interesting.
This is scary.
Darth Maul will excel in phase two and phase three as you're inside. I mean, he's a great mobile attacker. He's going to sit there with his lightsaber.
Especially close quarters, too. So he's absolutely perfect for that.
Absolutely. I mean, some of his abilities you can see here, he's got that spin attack. He's able to just rush in and out of combat and just take guys out in the process.
It was funny, I was talking to Musou earlier, and he was using Darth Maul, and he was saying how, there's Boba Fett as well, but he was talking about how he wishes Darth Maul could reflect. I was like, if he could reflect, he'd be too strong.
He'd be way too strong.
That
was a good flank by Boba Fett and Maul. Just shredded the clone army, unfortunately.
What role does Boba Fett fill in this battle?
Boba Fett is definitely a hunter-killer, so if the clone army is able to get some of their heroes in play, like, this is where Boba Fett will really shine. Is with that jetpack of his, he's able to kind of float above the battlefield, fire off some rockets, and really just take out an individual target.
And so what difference does he have from the last game?
From the last game, we've given him a bit of new tricks. He's got a new concussion rocket that will really disorient players completely. He also has this rocket barrage instead of just one rocket. He's able to really just lay down and suppress the fire.
Nice. Also, one thing to keep in mind, we saw the V2, here we go, but on the clone side, you know, there are specialist characters that you can pick up as well. We haven't seen much of it yet, but that would be the clone jump trooper.
That's right.
Very different from the standard, like, assault class or heavy class. It has the jump jets that you love from Battlefront, the original.
That's right.
Brought back here, but now focused on the central class.
Exactly.
Yeah, we're back to Boba Fett here with his rocket jumps there.
He's shredding.
He will just lay down so much firepower. It's intense.
Oh,
they got him, though.
Down. Jesse was able to find him on that one. Yep. But here comes some officer gameplay here.
Oh, good. Finally, somebody playing some support.
Support people matter, too.
They do. You got to give them some love. We're the linchpin of the team, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Now, what is his 2 exactly? His 2 is the healing ability?
His 2 ability is that, yeah, exactly. It's that healing ability. It gives you a little bit of buff for your little over health, but it also heals you back up. So it's, oh, we got some of the jump troopers.
Oh, boy. And here we go. It's getting ready for phase 3 in just a little bit. There's a jump trooper. We talked about him before. Jump trooper, super fun to play. But again, you know, it's attached to a specialist now, so not everyone's going to have it equipped, although it was really fun in the original battle.
That's right.
But I am going to be excited to hop in the jump trooper and shred people myself.
I mean, I know a lot of people love the jump pack. Oh,
jeez! Oh, now we've got Rey! Not going to lie, I'm super excited to play as her.
She's quite a powerful character.
Don't run!
She got out of that one really quickly. But
The droid! Fallen by a
Finished
simple droid.
No, but
so
Rey has,
how does her
Rey has
mind
a
trick affect enemies?
Absolutely. So Rey's mind trick is something that against all enemies, they'll be confused for a little bit, and your controls will kind of, you know, work against you, making you a little bit more vulnerable to attack.
Just so you guys know, this is when it gets insane. Because there's so much going on here. Sure. And, was that a little Han?
We saw a little Han, yeah.
Are we going to get some Han?
I hope so. But I mean, you saw it earlier. So every time you finish a life, we'll show you how many battle points you have. And some people have enough points to get those reinforcements. And especially this late in the game, you'll see a lot more of these special classes coming out, a lot more of the heroes coming out. So again, this jump trooper here, you know, with his rocket launcher and his jump pack, trying to be mobile, trying to fly into that last zone and capture a point.
This is really where heavies are going to thrive as well.
Because, my goodness, you just see him tearing through
the doorway. Just absolutely dominating the clones. They need to push out. They need to fight this one out here. There are so many lives left that the Separatists have to their team. They could really run through this. The clones have to start acting fast, because if they cap it, that will be it. The Separatists will win this game.
It's not looking so good for my boys in the clone army.
I'm a Separatist fan. so I'm excited.
I'm just going to go on whichever team wins.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
I'm not going to be too picky here.
Okay, you should jump and ship. I understand that. You know, no loyalties. Maybe you are Sith after all.
Ooh. Maybe I am.
Oh, who knows?
Shots fired.
Shots fired.
Yeah, so in this third phase, though, in the droids are trying to capture that throne room. So you can see here, if you remember, it's just this is the main throne.
And this is such super close quarters. Do you have any like sort of strategies that you would?
Absolutely. I mean, if you're the clones, you're hoping that. Oh, geez.
Han Solo just getting torn up.
It's gonna be trouble.
It's like too soon, man. I can't relive Force Awakens again. You know, like don't do it.
Darth Maul is just destroying absolutely everything. I mean, is there any tips to like taking him down?
I mean, you want to try to combined arms fire.
Oh.
The tip is blasters.
Run away, baby, run away.
Run away and just shoot the crap out of Darth Maul.
MVP.
Oh man.
He was our MVP. Look at that.
Nice stuff. Moose up. Congratulations. 36 kills he ended up picking up there, man.
My goodness.
Well, guys, that was it. What did you guys think?
Intense.
Not bad. I'm lying. It was freaking awesome. I love it. It's so good. It's like, I love the class-based gameplay personally. Because again, you can really get your squad, your friends, to get together and say like, hey, I want to, you know, run the officer, and we're going to do some highlights here. Maybe that wasn't the best highlight.
Not the best highlight.
You know, because although maybe it was.
Let's take a look at some of these highlights.
Oh,
I think it's just a crash montage. I think that's what we're going to do at this point. Just all crashing all the time. I'm down with that.
But it was Moosuck. I mean, he's sitting there, you know, getting as many battle points as he can before his next life. I mean, that's what you want to try to see with this battle point system. You want to either snowball your points, keep earning them. Keep building, getting more and more things.
Yeah, that's right. And again, you know, just the game. One thing I do want to compliment the team on, you know, EA and DICE, just the way the game looks. It's so beautiful, especially seeing this part of the Star Wars universe brought to life. The way that you guys really managed to do so. I mean, kudos on that one. Once again, you know, just dropping jaws everywhere.
We try. I mean, the team back home is amazing. They do incredible things. I mean, you can see it looks so pretty. Look at this laser fire. It's intense, and it looks beautiful.
It really does look incredible.
So good. We're just gushing right now. You know, like, we get it. The game looks good. You know, definitely. Oh man, but that was awesome. And overall, I mean, you know, I have to say, like, I can't wait to get my hands on it. I can't wait to coordinate with my friends. You know. And destroy the clone scum. I can't
that
wait
hurts.
For that.
Clone scum.
You know, exactly. Separatists.
Well, guys, that was so awesome. Now, if you guys are in LA, you can come join us at FanFest this weekend. And if you come down on Monday, we've got a chance for you guys to win a trip to Gamescom in Germany this August. All you have to do is come and play, which is, I mean, that's not asking too much. And you have to be the best player of your match, and you guys will be entered to win a trip for two to Cologne, Germany, and a full pass to Gamescom.
I've been there plenty of times. It's one of the most ridiculous conventions ever, if you happen to go. It's insane. It's massive. So if you don't get the trip, you're going to be really sad. But if you do get the trip, you and a buddy, you're going to have a good time. It's a fun time. Hopefully, I'll see you there.
Well, if you guys like Star Wars like we do and you guys want to play as your favorite heroes and villains, you guys can download Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes right now on Android or iOS. And you can play as any of the iconic characters.
All right, I think we're done. So thank you so much for watching this.
I also heard making Battlefront 2.
Don't turn this off. Prayer requests, anything you want to talk about, let me know. I appreciate so much, and God bless you, and take care of yourself. And we'll see you tomorrow for some more of E3 streaming. So now I'm going to go back hosting IGN, see what they're going to say. Take care, guys.